Okay, hello cloud gurus, how y'all doing? I'm Scott Pletcher, and this week on AWS This Week, Redshift gets a nifty new feature, application load balancers get gRPC support, and we get our hands on a massive new EC2 instance. Plus, we'll announce the coveted Guru of the Week award. Stick around. Good news for all you web application developers out there. Application load balancers are now capable of supporting end-to-end HTTP2 and gRPC. HTTP2 has been around for a while, and it's an improvement over HTTP 1.1 by changing the way the data is transported between the client and the server, resulting usually in better performance. Better performance means faster web applications. gRPC is an open source remote procedure call framework that uses HTTP2 and has become quite popular among application developers. You can also use ALB's content routing features to inspect the gRPC calls and route them to specific target groups based on the service and method request. Recently, AWS announced that you can now use Lambda functions as user-defined functions right in Redshift. User-defined functions, or UDFs, are little chunks of custom code that you can embed directly in your Redshift SQL statements. Now, because these are Lambda functions, you can use any language that Lambda supports, even bring your own custom runtime. One such use case for this functionality is tokenization. Tokenization is a strategy by which you can obscure and dynamically replace sensitive data with some other non-sensitive value as a sort of stand-in. You could, for example, use a Lambda UDF in your insert statement that dynamically calls out to some other system and exchanges a credit card number for a harmless token, thus keeping payment card numbers out of your Redshift database and therefore outside the scope of PCI audits. This week, AWS announced a new EC2 instance of massive scale. The P4D instance is designed for heavy-duty machine learning and high-performance computing applications. Now, the new instance only comes in one size right now, sporting 96 vCPUs, 1.1 terabytes of system memory, 8 terabytes of SSD storage, and capable of 400 gigabit per second network throughput. The instance also contains 8 NVIDIA A100 Tensor Core GPUs with 320 gigabytes of GPU memory. Now, these monster beasts are only available in US East 1 and US West 2 right now, and will set you back just under $33 per hour on demand. But they are also available as spot instances, reserved instances, and part of savings plans. According to AWS, the P4D instance delivers up to 2.5 times better performance at up to 60% lower cost than the equivalent P3 resources on machine learning training tasks. And no, the math still doesn't work out for profitable Bitcoin mining. Yes, the time is upon us to reveal this week's Guru of the Week. Congratulations go to Ian Evans, an enterprise architect from San Jose, California. A lovely swag pack is on its way to you as I speak. If you'd like to have a go at this week's Guru of the Week challenge, please check out our forum link below. That, my friends, is all the AWS news that's fit to print this week. For more AWS and A-Cloud Guru goodness, be sure to click those subscribe and notify buttons, or just give us a thumbs up and drop us a line down in the comments. Stay safe, take care of one another, and keep being awesome, cloud gurus.